What's good in the web? This your man Q back again. And I'm sorry, it's better late than never. You know what? But it, at this time that this video is coming out on the West Coast, I still made that Thursday. I still made it. So many of y'all know I started watching One Piece last year during the global miasma. I mean, seriously, it wasn't anything else to do but One Piece and, well, Animal Crossing. And I just recently started reading the manga.
The manga.
And I seen some new characters that made me say, you know what? It's that time. It's that time for speculation. Who's gonna be the new member of the Straw Hats crew? Greatest aspects about One Piece, other than the adventure, is trying to find out who is going to be the new crew. So I've comprised a few pros, cons, jobs, and everything else in between of who just might join the Straw Hats crew. But before we go any further, interweb, if you do like this video, make sure you give it a like. And if you're new to my channel, I did that because the YouTube bar, the subscribe bar is going to appear right here. Like, it's probably already here now. If you're new to my channel and you like anime, games, entertainment, everything else in between, go ahead and subscribe. I make videos Monday through Friday. They're not always going to be late like this. I do stream on Saturdays here on YouTube and Monday, Wednesday, and Friday over on Twitch at twitch.tv/TheGeekShow. I butchered that. It's going to be right here. Just, if you want to see me play some RPGs, some Smash Bros. Little games, look, real chill vibe. It's going to be right here. X Drake, his job will be one really simple. He's muscle. He definitely fit as a soldier. His powers. As far as his powers, Drake ate the Riri no Mi fruit that allows him to transform into a Azorus, a half man, half dinosaur that has rampaging strength and power and above average speed for a dino for that size. As far as his fit, he's a secretly pervy, not so secretly pervy type of guy. So he would fit quite well in with Brooke and with Sanji. Not so sure with Nami and Robin though. His pros, he's an ancient Zoan user and the Straw Hats need one. His cons, Drake's well, kind of like a busted and forgettable character, which, if you notice, on all the Straw Hats, each one has a unique spark that makes them stand out from pretty much everybody else on other people's crews and everybody else in the world. Also, well, we kind of got enough pervy dudes on the crew and only two females right now. Bentham, also known as Mr. Two, would actually fit quite nicely on the Straw Hats. I could see his job definitely being a strategist, using his power of the main no me fruit that allows him to change appearance and look like anyone that he wants to look like. That paired with all of his trickery and deceit from the years and years and years of his dirty work would be a very valuable asset. As far as fit goes, Luffy and the other crew love him. Bentham offers another form of comedy and his ability to change his appearance would be a plus in many, many situations. As far as his goals, I think it's kind of simple. Redemption. We already seen that in the Impel Down arc when he helped Luffy out. His pros, paired with the lookalike abilities and his years of trickery, he would definitely add a much needed game plan for many situations that Luffy and the Straw Hats seem to always rush into. Cons, we haven't seen Bentham in a little bit since we left him in Impel Down. So we don't really know where he's at or what he's doing. Even though his ability paired with his trickery is really good, he still has to touch someone with his right hand And the further we get along in the story, not every enemy is going to allow you to do that. I wanted to see Boa as a Straw Hat since Boa was introduced all those arcs ago. Her job would be one that would be very simple. She'd be more muscle and take the title as the Empress of the Sea, as one of the former Severn Warlords. Her powers would come in handy too. She would add as another Haki user who possesses strength, speed, and is feared throughout the seas. Boa ate the Maramara no Mi fruit that basically allows her to make her opponents fall drunk in love with her. As far as fit goes, she fit in the crew pretty nicely because she's a woman, which the ratio is pretty bad. That, and she's a great fighter even without her devil fruit powers. Her goals? Very simple. To marry Luffy and become Queen of the Pirates. Her pros? Along with being a female, her Haki usage, fighting experience, control of her own crew, and the backing of an island will grant additional resources for future arcs ahead. And as much as I love to see her on the Straw Hat's crew, her infatuation with Luffy could actually be more hindrance than help. I know I'm not the only one that had been wanting to see Vivi on the Straw Hat since way back in Alabasta. As far as her job, she was once a spy and had some pretty good gift to gab skills, so I could definitely see Vivi being a mediator. Although there had been word that she would eventually eat a devil fruit. At this point in time in the story, yeah, she's still powerless. As far as fit, she's been there, done that, and was literally the original ally for the Straw Hat's crew way back on Alabasta. So her personality fits quite well with everybody else on the crew. And it would also give her time to get to know all the new members of the crew, like Jinbei and Brooke, Frankie, and even seeing Robin in a new light. Her pros, you're gonna hear this a lot on this list. She's a female, and she has strong ties that date way back to Alabasta with the Straw Hats. That, and she's a princess, so she has more than a little pull in certain situations. Cons, Vivi's still weak. Plus, like a few other people on this list, her obligations as a princess will probably keep her sidelined for rejoining the crew. Otama, I can't really see having a job, because she's still a little kid. She's only about 8 or 9 years old during the events here on Wano. So I do see her just being a retainer or just a regular crew member, kind of like how Bucky and Shanks were with Roger. Her powers? Otama ate the Kibi Kibi no Mi devil fruit that allows her to create dango from her cheeks. These dangos make any animal that eats one utterly tame and under her control. Tama not only fills a much needed role on the crew by being another female, but she also has a budding relationship with Chopper, which I can only imagine the comedic situations that those two would get into. She also has ties with Ace, who when she first met, begged him to take her to sea. She most importantly has a strong relationship with Luffy, as we've seen the beginning of the Wano arc. Her goals? She wants to escape the tragedies of her past life in Wano and adventure the seas. Pros? Another female crew member. And she can control animals with her devil fruit power. The cons? She's only 8 years old, and Luffy might be reluctant to let her join the crew because of her age, even as a Caesar. His job wouldn't change. He'd definitely still be a scientist. And we all know, as far as powers go, he's got some of the best that we've seen in One Piece. Eating the gas gas fruit allows him to create, manipulate, and transform into gas at will. He can float, fly, and go into places that normal beings can't. As far as his fit, much like a lot of the used-to-be villains on the Straw Hats, Caesar would surprisingly fit in with the Straw Hats very well. We've already seen some of his empathetic gestures after the events in the cake art, and he's a scientist, which the Straw Hats don't have and need. Not only could he help out Frankie with switching cola to maybe something like plutonium or some other reusable energy for the Sunny, but he could also help out Usopp with some of his inventions and Chopper when it comes to medicine. As far as his goal, it's very similar to Zoro wanting to be the strongest swordsman and Luffy wanting to be the king of the pirates. Caesar wants to be the greatest scientist in the world. He also has nowhere else to go since everybody's after him. So his time with the Straw Hats could be one of a redemption tour. He's a scientist, a much needed Logia user, and he's a clown. The cons, he's done a lot of dirt. And a few of the people on the Straw Hats might not trust him. Namely, Chopper. Carrot, a long-standing fan favorite and ally. Carrot's job would be something that she's already been doing the moment she hopped aboard the Sunny. A fighter and a lookout. And also, she's a great artist. When it comes to powers, as a meek, Carrot is a natural fighter with enhanced strength, speed, and stamina. Along with her innate abilities, she can also use Electro. And like other minks, when looking at a full moon, she can awaken into her so long transformation that boosts her Electro and other physical attributes dramatically. Carrot is a great fit for the Straw Hats, and just as an ally, she has already proved herself to be a valuable asset to the crew. She also fills in that much needed female role. Plus, she's an artist, something that the Straw Hats don't have. Although she tends to draw things with the feminine twang, her goals to adventure the world and live out her dreams. Her pros, she's a female, an artist, a lookout, quick, can fight, and she's a mink, which the Straw Hats don't have. Her cons, with all the other bigger personalities on the crew, she tends to get lost sometimes. That, and she didn't properly have her own arc like many of the other crew members had before they joined. Whether you initially thought she was a female or you initially thought she was male, the moment Yamato stepped on the scene, we as fans instantly said, she's going to be a Straw Hat. Her job? A soldier and a diarist. Following some of the path of Odin, she likes to write everything down. Her powers? Being the daughter of Kaido, shouldn't be surprised that she has super strength, resilience, and that she's a haki user. Along with that, she's also a devil fruit user. She accidentally ate the mythical Zoan Ino Ino no Mi devil fruit, which allows her to transform into a wolf deity. Her fit? She's a female! And she shares a hate for her father, Kaido, much like all the Straw Hats and the rest of the world. And her exuberant personality, almost mimicking Odin's, will constantly push the Straw Hats in many situations. Her goals? She wants to follow in the footsteps of Odin and does her best to imitate him in all her actions, even reprising some of his classic feats verbatim. Her pros, along with being a strong female character, as well as a mythical Zoan type, which the crew doesn't have, she adds more strength to bolster the crew. Cons, not really many cons, unless you want to count the fact that she's the daughter of Kaido. So, Interweb, who do I think is going to join the crew in the end of it? So, Interweb, who do I feel is going to be joining the crew at the end of everything? Well, we've already seen that Oda has a thing that he does. When we first started our adventure, we met non-Devil Fruit users like Zoro, Nami, Usopp, and Sanji. Then we got a little stranger the further we went down when we got our crew. We were introduced to Chopper, Robin, Frankie, and Brooke, which all had their own special powers and or Devil Fruits, minus Frankie, who was a cyborg, and that was, you know, a weird ability too. And now we're introduced to a whole host of animalistic type of characters. We've already been introduced to Jinbei from the Fishman tribe, and he's an helmsman. So when I thought about who are going to be the last three characters, because I think there's going to be three more that join the crew before everything is said and done, and we reach the final island and fight the great fight against the world government, I feel that we're going to finally see Carrot join the Straw Hats crew as a lookout and as someone else who can fight. Plus, she's an artist. Joined because her female representation, as well as she is part of the Beastman tribe or Beastman pirates, because her father, Kaido, is the head of everything, and she has a fox deity, which also has a link to being an animal. Oh, I didn't mention that Carrot's a mink, so that also checks off the animalistic part within these next four characters. And then lastly, I would say that it's going to be Otama, who has the ability to control animals. I don't think because of her age that she's going to be an official crew member yet. She's only 8. So I do feel that she's going to join the Straw Hat crew because of Ace and because of Luffy, you know, keeping his word to Ace, the same thing with Yamato, that he's going to take them too, which would give 3 more female characters, and all of the characters will have animalistic traits. Then before it all said and done, I feel that it's going to be one more character who joins, and that character will be Caesar the Clown. Not only is he a clown, which would shore up part of the clown race, which Luffy has a whole bunch of refugees of every different type of species, but he's also a scientist who would not only help out Chopper, but help out Franky, and also help out the rest of the crew with his scientific inventions. Also, he has a lot to atone for. But Interweb, what do you think? Who do you think is going to be the next Straw Hat member? Do you agree with any of the crew that I mentioned? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you're new to my channel and you like the content that you see, make sure you hit that like button. It really helps me out a lot. YouTube be looking and see if you got likes, you got comments. That's how them robots get the videos pushed out. So much obliged if you do. And if you're new to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with anime, games, entertainment, and everything else in between. And as always, in the web, remember to eat, sleep, geek, repeat. I'll holler at y'all tomorrow. Deuces!